Good morning, friends. Wednesday, April 28th. It's good to come to you through video. Some of you know that I was away for a few days this past week. In fact, last Thursday, I was driving down to North Carolina to be with my covenant group. And on the way down through the hills of West Virginia and even sometime into Virginia, there were snow flurries that were happening on the drive. Nothing sticking, of course, but there was snow. And then yesterday, when I drove back from North Carolina to Pittsburgh, it was 87 degrees. So winter and summer, and it made me think of a hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness. And then a few nights ago, there was the full pink moon, or the pink full moon, and it was bright and beautiful, and that made me think of this same hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness. Let me read you the verse. Verse 2 of that hymn. Summer and winter, and springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above, join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. And then verse 3 is, pardon for sin and a peace that endureth, thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide, strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow, blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. And the refrain, you know, great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Boy, I don't know about you, but that is a refrain that I keep singing over and over again in these days, and to remind myself and to live into the promise that God is faithful and doesn't change, even though so many other things are changing around us. The weather is changing. Our way of life seems to have changed. Guidelines, restrictions, thoughts, understandings, all changing. The one thing that doesn't change is God and his faithfulness. We have much to be grateful for, that we know that and understand that. The verse that has resonated with me in these last few days comes from 1 Thessalonians 5, verses 16 and following. It simply says this, and you know these verses. It says, be joyful always. Pray continually. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Just a word of encouragement for us in these days to remember those things. Be joyful, always. Pray continually and give thanks in all circumstances. Those are the disciplines of the follower of Christ. Those are the practices of the Christian. And so let me encourage you to wrap your mind around that and to think about those things in this day and the days coming up. I understand that Dr. Gordon had a wonderful message on Sunday and that worship was glorious. We are so blessed here at Elf and Wild Church. I wanted to give you just a hint of what's coming in May, because there's a lot going on the Sundays in this month. May 2nd, upcoming this week, we will have communion, and it'll be Confirmation Sunday. We have three young ladies that are going to read their statements of faith. They've already been accepted and received into the membership of our church by the elders. They were questioned and examined on their statements of faith and what they believed, and now they are officially a part of this body of Christ that we call Elf and Wild Church. So it'll be wonderful to hear their statements and to pray for them as they begin this new journey of following Jesus in their lives at such a young age. And then on May 9th, we will have the next generation, or a younger generation, of Elf and Wilders leading us in worship on Youth Sunday. Our junior and senior high students we'll be taking the reins and doing the prayers and offering the music and giving the message and sharing their gifts in different ways. And that will be so exciting. What a wonderful thing to appreciate and be encouraged by the fact that God is raising up new generations of Christ followers, of people who believe in Jesus as Lord and Savior, who will live their lives based on that truth and that foundation. And they will lead us in worship on May 9th. May 16th, there's not a whole lot going on that Sunday that's out of the norm, so we'll look forward to that. But on May 23rd, it's Pentecost, and we will celebrate the coming of the Holy Spirit in a powerful way 2,000 years ago and talk about what it means for that Holy Spirit to be present with us in the church these days. That afternoon on the 23rd, we'll be doing some projects, some activities to help neighbors around the community and even here at church. So it'll be a service day. And so if you can participate in that, look for that information and sign up to be a part of that. And then finally, on May 30th, which is Memorial Day weekend, we will have worship, regular worship on Sundays, but a particular focus on May 30th will be celebrating our sister in Christ, Carolyn Hervey, as she retires from 40 plus years with the Elfinwald Preschool. So many years ago, Carolyn was that founding director of one classroom in the basement of Fellowship Hall and of the Christian Education Building. And now, look at the ministry and outreach that has resulted in her faithfulness and so many others joining her in caring for the children of this community and doing so in the name of Christ, teaching them about Jesus, sharing with them the love of God that we know in his Son. So we'll have a great celebration and look for information on that. That'll be Sunday, May 30th. Wanted to give one last update on some specific things going on. We have secured a second mission trip week for the youth for this summer. On August 1st, both junior and senior highs are invited to go with us up to Erie. That's Sunday through Friday. And we'll be spending the week there working in downtown Erie and serving the least of these. Chuck Nelson is the church plant pastor. The church is called The Cross, and they serve the homeless and the downtrodden in the downtown section of Erie. So we will be working in that neighborhood. And Chuck tells me that it's the zip code with the lowest median income in the whole country. It's not too far from here. So if you're a junior or senior high, if you have a junior or senior high or know someone who's a junior or senior high and wants to go and experience serving others, washing their feet in sort of ways, then please look for that information. August 1st, we'll be going up to Erie. Of course, the senior highs are going to Kentucky in July, and May 15th is the deadline to sign up for that. So I hope that they will be encouraged to get their names in to go on that trip as well. I had two more things that I wanted to share with you as we move forward into this week. The first one is to remember those who are struggling in this season for many different reasons. But specifically in this last week, our sister in Christ, Elizabeth Popovic, has been in the hospital back three times. She went in with pneumonia, she tested positive for COVID, and she came home, went back, came home, went back, and came home a third time and went back and is still there. She's improving, but please pray not only for her health, but for her husband, Matt, as he loves his wife in this time, but also cares for their two sons, as well as being a teacher at the same time. So please keep the Popovic family in your prayers. And finally, there is one of our senior saints who has been cared for by another fairly senior saint for a long time now. And we needed to get some help for that caregiving. I got a call last week and I sent out one text to six or seven ladies. And within 24 hours, we had care for our sister in Christ every night of the week and several mornings each week. And I was overwhelmed by the response of God's people to care and love one another, to care for and love one another. And I just wanted to lift up that witness of people giving of themselves to care for one another in this community of faith, this family that we call Elfinwald Church. We are blessed. And so we should be grateful always and rejoice in those good gifts that God gives to us in one another. I'll say more in the next few weeks, but I'm really committed and convinced, I guess, that the real presence of Christ today in the world is the church, the body of Christ, the physical church, the physical body of Christ being present in the world to shine the light of God's truth and God's love for others to see. And particularly as we head to Pentecost, we'll talk a lot more about that. Know that we care about you. And I'm convinced more and more that this is indeed one big family who loves one another in the name of Jesus. And so I hope that you know that we care about you. And if there's anything we can do for you, do not hesitate to call us, email us, text us. We'd be glad to reach out and walk alongside of you in any way that we can. It is wonderful that we have had more and more people coming back to worship. It really does matter when we're together. So if you're vaccinated, if you feel safe and comfortable, let me encourage you with all I can to come back together for worship on Sundays. We'll be inside at 8:30, still wearing our masks. We'll be outside at 11:10. We're singing in both services. And so we're making our way back gradually to that space, that time when things were seemingly more normal. It might never be the same, but we're inching our way and moving forward. I hope you can be encouraged by that. We miss you. We love you. Know that we care. Take care and have a good day. God bless you.